Well, first of all, to give you a minimum idea of my talk, my passions are video games and YouTube too. And how did this be related with what I come to tell you today? Perhaps because the video games are the main addiction on teenagers nowadays. Their parents think that are a bad influence on them and do not let them play. This leads to some problems that are causes, for example, in not so good school marks. That is why I will defend you today why should parents leave more free time for children and why children respond badly to their parents when they are asked to stop playing. This talk idea comes from one personal anecdote. Many boys and girls on my course were stressed by their school marks in November, but the funny thing is that they were not concretely stressed by these school marks, these comments, and these exams from school. They were worried about how their parents would respond to these comments, these school marks, and these exams from school. This obviously led me to think, and I wrote a brainstorming full of ideas, full of arguments, to understand why video games are bad, and from that brainstorming, I will be able to counter-argument. I started my research writing out everything I found on the internet, and the surprising thing was that video games have many positive points by which children can learn and develop their mind. The one that surprised me the most was an investigation made by a group of scientists and video games designer called Neuronasser. Neuronasser was most focused in how video games affect to elderly people. These elderly people need to play a virtual card game while they were doing other home tasks. After 12-hour testing, Neuronasser certified that video games prevent the brain aging and also develop other skills such as attention and memory. This investigation had me encouraged to search for more because I thought, if video games are good for elderly people, why are not good for children? Then it was when I found that a group of scientists certified that video games also develop skills like motor and visual attention and socialization. It's true that some of the actual games produces opposite effects, and I think that it's for that type of games that parents were worried. Because big companies like Nintendo are trying to produce new funny games that also help the brain to develop other skills, such as Mario Bros. That a group of scientists certified that Mario Bros. Increases the volume of gray matter. Gray matter is the responsible of muscles, language, and perception of sense. After all this research, I think about how video games affect to me and my friend, and what skills develop over our brain. So, a few days at school, I saw from my friends and my personal skills. I checked that the girls and boys of my course that play video games knew a lot of tech and also had a good ideas for the future. So, I came to the conclusion that video games increases and develop our creativity. Creativity will be very important in not too distant future, just like tech. In order to survive in a world that humans need to come up with ideas that machines and computers cannot produce. I came to the conclusion that video games will be very important in the near future. So now I have more excuses to play more time. Thank you.